Hey, you're bare feet.
Yes.
All right, let's go.
Nobody would ever believe you can move that fast.
Yeah. All right. Now we did that. Relax. Okay. One time running in church, you're not going to get yelled at. What was different? The second race. Simon? What's that? Okay. Well, a couple weeks ago, Mr. Hodnick preached a sermon that I missed about a race, because I was at a race, actually. I heard it was a good sermon. I still haven't got the tape, but I'm assuming that it would be because something to the effect that we are still all in a race in life, and as we race through life, sometimes we carry our burdens and our sins and things with us that tend to weigh us down and make it harder to race. To run a race. So this morning I wanted to encourage you by saying Hebrews 12:1. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a huge crowd of witnesses to the life of faith, let us strip off everything that slows us down, especially the sin that trips us up, and let us run with endurance the race that God has set before us. So one of the things in our life, not only sin, but what are the things that we, well, before I ask that question, I would like to be honest with you. There's things in life that I do sometimes that tend to take my focus off God, like spending too much time watching Fox News, working too much according to Mrs. Rittenhouse, and playing on my computer. Not necessarily sins yet, but what are the things that you guys tend to do that take your time away from God and focus on Him? It could be good things that we do. Yeah, schoolwork. How about sports? Do we spend too much time focusing on sports? They can be good things, but if we spend too much time focusing on things away from God, it takes our eyes off of Him. So, the Bible encourages us to lighten our packs, get rid of the things that take our eyes off of the Lord, and you will see that your load will get lighter, and it will be easier to run your race with, and you'll be able to run lighter, freer, and easier. Mrs. Rittenhouse has a present for you. What's that? After church? And I don't want to disappoint you. She ain't Linda Andrews. She didn't bake nothing. But she went out and found it for you. So, thank you, guys. I'm glad to know that I can still beat you all, no matter how heavy my back is. Thanks. See me or Cheryl afterwards.